Let's talk panoramas and HDR and HDR panoramas and a number of ways that you can approach this. So here I have a couple of example panoramas that I shot recently. These are just using three exposures, but you can shoot many more. Sometimes I shoot as many as seven exposures, but for your first time ever, I don't think that's necessary. This first one I want to look at because this is probably the most likely to be similar to how you shoot, because this was using not a fisheye lens. I'm currently using the metadata filter, and under custom filters, I've added exposure info so that I can sort these based on how they were exposed. And here you can first off take a look at how this was shot just to see the basic rules of panorama. So again, I shoot three cylinders, a cylinder meaning going in a circle while holding your shutter button down. And every time I go around, I try and make sure that there's at least a one-third jump. So here you can see like this little mark where the phone booth or the phone pole happens. That's at about a one-third mark over, right? Next one over, it's moved about one-third to one-quarter. So this makes sure that every time I shoot these photos, there's overlap. I use a mnemonic of shooting towards the sun, so the sun is always my start point, just because that is something I've been doing for so long that I can't not do it. And also, it's a good way to make sure that you don't end up with overlap. So the next thing that happens is after this first cylinder, by the way, there's my dog.